Hey everybody, I have yet another really cool unique meal serp, or not unique, but for me it's unique. I've been wanting one of these puppies for a long time, and finally just got a decent deal on one and took it up. So this is the model 1886 slash 93 Lebel rifle. It's a French rifle, designed in 1886, of course, the designation. 1886 apparently had some problems with it. So in 1893 they came out with some modifications, and this is the end result. And they used this up past World War II. This is used by several different countries. From the time it was introduced until its replacement. But the French Foreign Legion, they always got issued Berthier rifles, and they always complained that this was so much better, and they wanted this. This one was manufactured by the Tulle Arsenal. I probably butchered that, but it's Tulle. There's like three or four different manufacturers, if I'm not mistaken. This thing is really cool. It's a this particular model is all matching numbers. Barrel, receiver, underside of the receiver right there. Matching number, bolt, and the stock, which is probably also right there, and right there, as you can see. I'll turn it. It's all matching serial numbers, so that's pretty cool. I'm pretty happy with that. I got this one from Empire Arms. If you haven't checked out that website, you might want to. He's got some really good deals on there. Great person to deal with too. No problems. I talked to him on the phone. We had a little bit of a snafu on the payment thing and got straightened out. So yeah, Empire Arms sold me this, and it's a great rifle. Somebody apparently decided to try and take the barrel off at one point and marred the shit out of it with a wrench or something. It's aesthetic. I'm not really concerned about it because I wanted it as a shooter and just to have one as an example of a World War I firearm. Because France was probably one of the most heavily involved countries of World War I, if you actually look at it. So, anyways, this thing is really neat. It's got a weird shaped bolt. It's kind of a skinny bolt handle, and it's a short action, you know, for what it is. It fires the 8mm Lebel cartridge, and go figure. But yeah, this is actually the first smokeless powder cartridge ever created, and this is their first rifle, you know, to shoot it. And it's pretty much like if you were to take a 7.62-5.4 and flare out the neck to 3.27 and scrunch it down a little bit, because it's shorter. It's only 50mm, but it's fatter, like it's really tapered, big round. So I'm pretty sure the capacity is close to a 7.62-5.4. Hand loaded those using 208 grain 327 diameter bullets from Buffalo Arms Company and PPU brass and 40 grains of IMR 4895. This thing has a bayonet. This one's a shortened version that they shortened, I think during World War II, or maybe it was sooner, I'm not quite sure. It's a cruciform bayonet, so that means that when you look at it from this angle, it's kind of forms a cross. It's pretty deadly. It'll go through a lot of clothing and stuff. This is the shortened one. It just fixes onto the end of the rifle. And yeah, there's really not much else to say about this. I'll show you how to load it when I go to fire it. Sights are a little weird. It's a V notch in the back, the blade in the front, and it's really small, really low profile, so we'll see how that works today. Yeah, you can go ahead and shoot this. I don't have really much more to add. Show you how to load it. It's kind of weird. It's got a 8-round tubular magazine underneath in the stock down there in the foregrip, so we'll show you that. And all right, we're gonna go ahead and shoot this thing now. To load it, you'll find that there's a little tray in there like a shotgun. When you rack the bolt back, it pulls that up, and then that would allow your round to go in the chamber like that. Okay, there's a little selector right here that's kind of hard to push. It's forward, the feed tray stays up, so it's a single shot mode. You load everything in for volley fire, old school style. 19th century. This is the end of the 19th century, so that was still that kind of like the Craig. This is the magazine cutoff equivalent. To take that off, you just move the selector back, push that down. Now to load this, I don't know if you can see in there's a tube in there, like it goes in, And to load this, you drop the round into the breech right there, or into the little feed tray, and push forward, and it stays in there. It's like a shotgun or a Winchester. It's a really cool design. I like it. And for this, make sure if you're going to be loading for this, make sure you have the brass. It's got the little groove on the outside of the primer, because that's where the bullet behind it will sit. So it sits like this in the magazine instead of right on the primer, which it's going to explode. That's why they had that weird rim around them. So in case you didn't know that. But this one, yeah, you can't angle it in and, you know, do that. You have to drop it all the way down, and then it'll go forward. Otherwise, it's really touchy. So, and this thing, like I said, holds 8 rounds just in the tube. Let me try and speed things up here. Now, to fire this, I'm going to be using single shot mode for the first little bit of it. So, I'm going to have that up. I'm going to flip that switch over so now that doesn't engage or whatever. And I'm going to load in one round at a time just to see. We're going to... You shot up the 75-yard target? Okay. I'm going to aim at the 75-yard target. And I've never fired one of these before, so I don't know how much it recoils. I heard they recoil a lot. So we shall see. It's not too bad, but it's pretty stout. You can definitely feel it's there. It's more like a push, like a black powder rifle. So, not as bad as I thought. Could be worse. Definitely there though. It's probably about like a Mosin Nagant 9130. Just a stout but not intolerable recoil. Now I'm going to flip the magazine on. I'm going to kind of do a little bit faster fire. That popped out. All right, spec. I did a chamber one. That's kind of cool. A lot of rounds for a rifle this old. All right. So we'll go up and check out the, that extracted weird. Shoot one more. Go up and check that out at 75 yards. So these are probably the well-aimed shots. I was holding about right here, and it's probably me shooting to the left as I always do. But yeah, that's a pretty good group right there. They're touching 3, 4, 5, 6. And then for fast firings, let's count them all. 3, 6, 9, 10, 11. There should be one more because I fired 12. Maybe I missed it. Anyways, that's probably the old man will probably do a little better than that at grouping. I was kind of nervous shooting it too. It's old, you know, it's an antique receiver. So that's kind of always nerve-wracking the first couple shots. But yeah, we'll let the old... Oh, right there is the last shot. Nice. All right, we'll let the old man shoot it now and see what he thinks. The old man's going to attempt to load this son of a bitch. Already fucking it up. Yeah, I had to use my pinky because it's small enough. That would probably suck in combat.
Yeah, it'd be pretty bad. Especially when that barrel starts getting real hot.
Well, yeah, that's the one thing the soldiers complained about is there's no hand guard on there. So when it gets hot, it's going to burn the shit out of you.
You're going to sit there and... Fry your
you got to drop them all the way down in there, otherwise they'll stick.
My pinky here,
just
like you did. That ain't strong enough.
There you go. Here's eight, and then hold on, just then, like put the bolt forward, rack it back. There you go.
All right, one in the chamber, and here we go.
And then, do you want to use a magazine or do you want to do single shot?
I'm gonna do single shot first, so I'll lock it up.
Perfect. Holy shit, you're getting it.
Yeah. Yeah. You can teach an old dog old tricks.
Cool.
All right. Here we go.
So the Lebel, 75 yards, the old man shooting her.
Well, that's got quite a kick to her.
Yeah, it's a big push. You just drop it right in that feed tray. That's the way it's supposed to chamber.
Yep.
So you don't break the extractor.
Oh. All right, not so bad, not so bad at all.
It's a heavy rifle, but it's tolerable.
All right, I will try the old.
Got it. I just found that you put your finger, like your thumb, on the trigger well, and then just kind of. It's kind of stiff. There you go.
Okay.
Now you gotta push that down.
Yeah. Oh, jeez. Oop.
Nope.
Oop.
Okay, hold on.
Hold on. We got a miss.
Well, you
misguided child here. Hold on. So let me stick this in here for now.
And just rack the bolt back a little bit.
Yeah. There she goes. All right.
Okay.
Okay, we've got all kinds of good stuff going on here. You know, acting as bad boys. Oh, we got a dropper there. I'm sick of that.
That is a loud rifle.
It's very loud.
Can imagine a bunch of those going off. Isn't that weird? You could feel the round coming out of the handguard.
Yeah, it's unbelievable. Yeah, that's it.
All right, we shall go down and check it out. Well, here's the old man's group. Apparently he was aiming right there, so it's shooting really high to the left. I don't know why mine was lower, so to the left. But yeah, it's grouping good. You know, it's a decent rifle. I just think we got to get it a little bit zero. This is our first time shooting it. I just got it a couple days ago. Literally 2 days ago. So, we should probably... Or no, I got it yesterday. Yeah, it came in the mail yesterday. So, yeah, we're going to have to zero this in. Now I'm going to try it at 100. I'm going to do some slow fire. I'll probably only do one magazine's worth. And then we'll do some fun stuff.
We'll load it one more time. Yeah, that's a pain in the ass. Just like the Craig, you got to have them loose. That's why I see why a lot of the countries like the Charger. It's all right there. You can't drop rounds individually. still, when you need it, that capacity is kind of a cool thing. You know, 8-hole rounds, and the other guy's got probably 5, unless he's British, but you're not fighting the British because you're French. So, I must have been 8. Alright. Okay, I'm gonna be slow fire at 100 yards. That was probably to the left. Yeah, I racked back on that too hard. Yeah, I can barely see the sights, the frickin' the heat. Coming off the barrel really bad. That'll be it. Let this baby cool down a little bit. Oh yeah, dude, that's bad. I don't have an upper hand guard, so that's freaking red hot. If you like go to bound or something and you grab it like this, you're, Jesus. Yeah. Three things that soldiers complained about was a tubular magazine being hard to load in combat, lack of the handguard, and then the way the sights are set up, because they said anything past 300 you really can't see or hit, and I'm kind of beginning to see that because it's kind of a weird sight. For 100 yards it's fine, but all right, we'll go down and check out the 100. It's probably all over the place, but we'll see how bad it really is. This time I was shooting offhand, or I mean sitting down, but it was unsupported, just my elbows, and shooting kind of fast, not really fast, but just average. They're all right there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, and that's a decent group for, you know, unsupported, just kind of sitting there. That's within about 3 inches. And then the rest of them are just kind of whatever. That's definitely a minute of man, for sure. Deer, any game. I mean, I'm sure that round will drop any game in North America. Probably Africa, too. I mean, that's a huge round. Yeah, that's okay. I'm good with it. That rifle's dead nuts on, accurate, and yeah, I like it. It's just really gets hot fast, and it's a bitch to load the tube magazine in combat. I mean, here at the range, it doesn't matter because you're not getting shot at. So, but I can see where it'd be a bitch. I don't mind it personally, but all right, you see the results right there at 100 yards. So now we're gonna do some fun stuff. I don't know if this constitutes cool shit, but since the old man was shooting left, he kind of wants to rectify that and see if that putting it on something affects the harmonics that bad. So he's going for 100 at the head. Two more, you should be able to hit them. And if you do get them in there, we'll know it. We can't rest that on anything.
Right. That could have a lot to do with it.
I don't see how it would affect the harmonics that bad, but maybe. Okay, we'll go down and check her out. All right, so that was a little high. And we're gonna try aiming a little bit lower because these things are battle sighted for 400 meters, as you can see. So. Big pile of brass. Feeling better about these?
Yeah, I'm at the base of the head. So hopefully we hit something. That's it, one more.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I haven't been counting. I was paying attention to that fucking animal going ape five. Shit. Alright. We'll check that out. We've come to the conclusion. Oh, well, that's a good shot.
Yeah.
I think you only fired four. So, still a little high. I think you were holding right here.
Right there.
So it's, yeah, it's battle sighted for 400 meters, like most rifles, like the Gewehr 98 and such. So that's why we had to aim a little bit low at 100. Yeah, good group though. Dead fucking center right there. Dead in the middle of the head. And in the top three right there. If you're holding center mass like I was, that'd definitely be a debilitating shot. That round, whew, that's a big round to be hit by. 208 grains of justice. So. All right, now I promise you we'll do the fun stuff.
So it's come to my attention that the Germans are now attacking, or the Austro-Hungarians or whoever. So I need to get up. And fire. This simulates how small a trench is because I'm pretty big for the time period. Oh boy, and they might be starting to ride back. Try and get as many of them as I can before they get back to their trench. Cool. Got a pretty decent count going. Get a couple more shots in. All right, up and over. All right, so now we're gonna be up. All right, time for the magazine cutoff to not happen. He's down, move on. All right, so on that one, I was waiting to run out of rounds, but I didn't. It was kind of like an Enfield. So yeah, I could see why it was kind of successful in World War I when you got the single shot version, you know, you load it in by yourself and, you know, then when you need the magazine, it's there with 8 rounds. So that's a pretty good deal. Bayonet, the original bayonets, like I think I stated in the earlier video, they were probably about that long. So you got more range and distance. This one was shortened later on, but it was a good deal, so picked it up. This thing is, that thing is steaming hot right now. Son of a bitch. I could imagine after an engagement or something, when you go to, you know, go back to your trench or whatever, grab it like that, you'd have the whole inside of your hand charred. So that wouldn't be fun. Yeah, you really don't notice the recoil that much when you're walking. It's pretty substantial though anyways, I could tell. Bolt smooth, I didn't have a single malfunction, you know, the whole time I was walking. So that was kind of cool, that was interesting. I was waiting to, you know, something to go wrong, but standing up here shooting it like this, didn't even have to look to see if around was chambering, and the sights are actually pretty good for close battle sights, I'll give them that. But I can see why for long distance it didn't work out that great. But yeah, just an awesome rifle, as usual. They're really hard to find now for cheap, or not cheap, but you know, whenever they pop up once in a while, Gunbroker or other sites, and you know, you might get lucky. I waited years to get this thing because I wasn't going to pay $800 for one. But yeah, hope you liked this video. I had a great time shooting this thing. It's an awesome piece of history. These things were used through World War II. They even got issued to German troops in World War II. They were the Gewehr 37 or something like that. I don't know, don't quote me on that. They were designated something issued to German troops in Volkssturm at the end of the World War II. So it's got a pretty impressive service life on it. But yeah, ask any questions as usual. Subscribe if you like this. I have plenty of other videos like this, and I'll be making some more cool videos of World War I firearms. Appreciate you watching. Thanks.